morning, everybody. In the previous video, we have seen that the Second World War started in the year 1939. Now, Japan also joined the Second World War, and since Britain and Japan were enemies, so the presence of Britain in India or the British in India was a threat for India also. And moreover, the Japanese had started occupying the eastern borders of India. So it was likely that Japan may enter into India. So Mahatma Gandhi wanted British to leave India as soon as possible. So he decided to launch a movement called Quit India Movement. He wanted the British to leave India immediately. And so on an address which he gave to the public on 7th August, he said that either the British should leave India or the Indians must die in that effort. And that is called do or die. So this slogan was given by Gandhiji, do or die. And on 9th August, a Quit India resolution was passed by the Congress. But before the movement could start, Gandhiji was arrested. But the arrest of Gandhiji did not stop the people from starting the movement. So demonstrations were held all over India. There were protests, there were hartals which were held everywhere, and especially the peasants and the youths participated in these protests and demonstrations. Now the people attacked the communication system and the symbols of state authority. Like, they attacked the post office, they attacked the police stations, they attacked the railways, telegraph, telephone lines were destroyed, and in many areas the people set up their own governments. Now what will be the response of the British because of all these activities? So as we know, it was brutal repression. The British started brutally repressing the people by attacking them, killing them. Many were severely injured, many were put into jail. So by the end of 1943, almost 90,000 people were arrested and 1,000 people were killed in the police firing. And even in many places where the crowd was gathered, the British, they used machine gun to fire from the aeroplanes. But even after so much of repression, the spirit of the Indians did not die out, and the British realized that now their days in India are only countable in fingers. This Quit India movement could help to bring down the British into their knees, and now the independence was not far.